हाँ सर,
ओके ऑलराइट। सो कम टू जेनेटिक एल्गोरिदम, सो दिस कम्स अंडर द फैमिली ऑफ नेचर इंस्पायर्ड एल्गोरिदम। ओके एंड इट रियली गॉट ट्रिमेंडस सक्सेस इन ऑप्टिमाइजेशन, यू नो, सर्च काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स। ओके एंड व्हाट इज द आइडिया? द आइडिया इज दैट यू फॉलो नेचर। ओके, यू फॉलो नेचर एंड नेचर हैज सम इनबिल्ट एफिशिएंसी। ओके, सो दैट मे बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ हाउ द बीज फाइंड और द स्वार्म्स फाइंड देयर फूड। ओके, दैट मे बी इन इन टर्म्स ऑफ सम अदर फेनोमेना, लाइक यू नो हाउ ए पर्टिकुलर प्रीडेटर्स हंट समथिंग। ओके, सो इन नेचर इट टर्न्स आउट दैट देर इज सम ऑप्टिमाइजेशन विच आर गोइंग ऑन। ओके, एंड दिस नेचर इंस्पायर्ड एल्गोरिदम्स एक्चुअली ट्राई टू मिमिक दिस थिंग। ओके, नाउ द आइडिया ओवर हियर इज दैट दिस इम्प्रूवमेंट ऑफ स्पीसीज। ओके, दिस इम्प्रूवमेंट ऑफ स्पीसीज कैन ऑल्सो बी थॉट एज एन ऑप्टिमाइजेशन प्रॉब्लम। सो हाउ वी कैन मॉडल इट दैट मे बी यू नो यू हैव ए इनिशियल सेट ऑफ स्पीसीज लाइक द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ ह्यूमन रेस हैज हैपेंड, राइट? सो यू हैव अ सेट ऑफ पॉपुलेशन, राइट? एंड देन व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इज दैट 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 पॉपुलेशन हैव गॉन थ्रू सम चेंजेस, हैव गॉन थ्रू रिप्रोडक्शन एंड हैज प्रोड्यूस्ड ए सेट ऑफ पीपल। ओके, ए सेट ऑफ पीपल हु आर सम वे बेटर देन द यू नो प्रीवियस जेनरेशन। सो दैट्स हाउ यू नो द फिटेस्ट आर सर्वाइव। ओके, सो इफ यू थिंक दैट देन इफ आई कॉल दिस जेनरेशन, सो फ्रॉम जेनरेशन टू जेनरेशन एक्चुअली ह्यूमन बींग हैज इम्प्रूव्ड। सो इम्प्रूव्ड मे बी ए डिबेटेबल टर्म, बट इम्प्रूव इन टर्म्स ऑफ मे बी देयर कोपिंग एबिलिटी विद द एनवायरमेंट। ओके, सो दैट्स हाउ यू नो दिस हैपन्स एंड जेनेटिक एल्गोरिदम एक्चुअली ट्राइज टू मिमिक दिस। ओके, सो देर आर टू थिंग्स। ओके, देर आर टू थिंग्स दैट नीड्स टू बी टेकन इन टू नोटिस ओवर हियर। सो इफ यू लुक एट हिल क्लाइंबिंग और इवन इफ यू लुक एट सिमुलेटेड एनीलिंग, वी स्टार्ट विथ अ पर्टिकुलर सोल्यूशन, राइट? सो वी हैव अ सोल्यूशन एंड वी ट्राई टू इम्प्रूव इट। इन कॉन्ट्रास्ट, इन जेनेटिक एल्गोरिदम वी स्टार्ट विथ अ सेट ऑफ पॉपुलेशन और रादर ए सेट ऑफ सोल्यूशन which is called as a population. Okay, so it is not one point in the hill that I start with, but I take multiple starting points. Okay, so you might be thinking at this point that it seems quite similar to iterated hill climbing plus, but please hold on to that thought. Okay, so this is the first thing, that I have a set of population, and as I explained previously, that this quality of the population actually improves from generation to generation. So the how genetic algorithm will work at a very high level, that I will have a set of population. Okay, then what I'm trying to do, so these set of populations are actually set of solutions to your problem. Okay, and then what I'm doing is actually I am you know making them go through some changes. Okay, I'm going to make them go through some changes, and I create another generation of population. Okay, another generation of population, and that's how this genetic algorithm works. Now, why do I stop? So, anytime you are studying about an algorithm, you need to understand that where what is the termination condition, where this algorithm will terminate. So, the termination can happen when so you can fix certain iterations, of course, which is not a very foolproof way. And another way is that you check maybe the average quality of the generation, and maybe when you have if I have some way to actually measure, if I have actually a way to measure how good a solution is, okay, or how good a particular member is in the population, then whatever may be the average quality, if I say maybe generation 1 my quality was 2, in generation 2, my quality is 3, in generation 4, my quality is 3.5, and gradually I might see that the change or the way it is improving is becoming quite flat. Okay, so, and like, you know, like you do even when you are training a neural network, anytime when you are in an iterative method, if you see maybe for 5 continuous iteration or 10 continuous iterations, you don't have a substantial improvement, you stop there. And that is probably the better way to find out or put a termination condition. Now, this genetic algorithm actually has a set of operators. Okay. There are 3 main operators. The first operator is called as selection. Okay. So, selection is about that not everyone will participate in this genetical improvement program. Okay. Who will participate? The fittest persons will participate. They will actually take part into creating new generation. Okay. Or maybe reproduction, you can see. Now, the question that comes is that how do I find who are fittest, right? So I have to have a mechanism by which I can say that, okay, this person or this solution is better than that solution, or this species, okay, or this representative of the species is better than this representative. This tiger is more fit than the other tiger. So how do I do that, right? So in our case, we can go ahead and use the heuristic functions that we are using. So genetic algorithm also leverages this heuristic function. Okay. All right. Now, the next step is recombination. Okay. So recombination is also called as crossover. So look at this very carefully. So what happens is, first of all, when I talked about selection, I told that that every member of the population or every possible solution will have a heuristic score or goodness of the fit or fitness of the solution attached to it. Okay. Now, what is the selection, how selection is attached to it? Okay. So selection is attached to it in this manner. So basically, if you are more fit, right, if you have a better value of the heuristic, then your chance of getting picked up for the next step, which is recombination, okay, is more. All right. So it may happen that there are 4 solutions like this, right? So, or maybe 5 solutions like this, which are A, B, C, D, and E. Okay. And basically, let's say that, you know, based on their fitness value, so what I do is I calculate everyone's fitness value and then I divide by the total fitness value. Okay. So maybe, you know, the value here is 5. Okay. The value here is 4. Then I have maybe 3. Okay. I may have 1. Okay. And so it is 5 plus 4 plus, yes, and let's say I have 2. Okay. So the total is 15. So I will say that probability of A getting selected for recombination is 5 by 15, which is 33%. Okay. Similarly, B is getting selected is 4 by 15, which will be maybe 27%, right? Getting 3 will be around 20%. Getting 1 will be around 6%. Okay. Getting 2 will be maybe around 13%, something of that sort. Okay. So more or less, you know, it is like this. So it is 27, right? More or less. So maybe 30, 60, 80, 86. Maybe let's make it 40. Roughly like. Now, as we are explaining in case of simulated annealing, that how do you actually probabilistically select something? So I'll generate a number as usual, and it may happen. And let's say the 5 numbers that got generated are like this. So the first number that got generated is, the first number that got generated is maybe 75. Okay. The next number that got generated was maybe 15. The next number that got generated was maybe 42. The next number that got generated was maybe 98. And the last number that got generated was maybe 2. Okay. Now, what we have done is we have actually made this 1 to 100 split between A, B, C, D, E. So, if it is maybe 1 to 33, I select A. If it is 34 to 60, I select B. If it is 61 to 80, I select C. If it is 81 to 86, I select D. If it is 87 to 100, I select E. So, that's the scheme. Okay. So, if I have selected 75, then what will be selected? C will be selected corresponding to this. Okay. Then what has been, what is there? 15. So, A will be selected. Then what I have is 42. Okay. And 42 means it will be B. 98 means it will be E. Okay. And 2 is it will be A. So, see what automatically what has happened is who was the most fit? A. A has come twice. And who was the least fit? It was D. See, D is not there in this population. So, this is what has happened in selection step. Is the selection part clear to you? Okay. Now, once the selection is over, what we are going to do is we are going to do a recombination. So, what you can think is that you are selecting a pair of solutions. You are selecting a pair of solutions and you are creating new solution out of that. Okay. So, this process is called as recombination. So, in selection, you have picked up good quality solution. In recombination, you are going to use, you are going to, use some property of both the solution and create new solution. You know, like a child, you know, inherits some property of the father and some property of the mother. So, the child solutions that we'll get will inherit some property of parent one and some property of parent two. Okay. So, how this works? Okay. So, how this is work is that you randomly, you know, choose a value between 1 to 8. Okay. So, let's say you choose a value 4. Okay. Or in this case, I think the value that you have got is 5. So, you have chosen this bit. Now, what has happened is that there is a crossover. So, the first 5 bits of the second parent has come to the first offspring or the first child. Okay. The rest are coming from parent 1. And similarly, the converse thing has happened for child 2. So, for child 2, the first 5 bits has come from parent 1 and the last 3 bits, or you can say that, you know, these genes, right? The genes are coming from parent 2. Okay. So, this is the idea of combining multiple solutions. And you can also understand that this is also a stochastic process. Why? Because you cannot know beforehand that what is going to be chosen as the crossover point, right? So, this is a stochastic process and now you have got a child. Now, there is one more thing that happens over here. So, there is something called as a crossover probability. Okay. So, a pair is selected, but they may not be recombined if they don't have a certain probability value. Okay. So, to have enough stochasticness, and please understand, more and more we bring this stochasticness, actually we are moving away from the exploitiveness of those greedy strategies, which had a tendency to get trapped in the local minimum. Okay. So, these are all exploratory strategies, stochastic strategies that we are, you know, building into our algorithms. Okay. So, we will have a crossover probability which generally have a value like maybe, you know, 0.7, 0.8 in this range. Okay. All right. So, if if that happens, it is good. So we recombine and put in the next generation. Otherwise, we may put them as it is in the next generation without recombination. Okay. And then there is a third thing, which is called as mutation. So the idea of mutation is, so sometimes what happens is that, you know, the father was also a very ordinary person and the mother maybe also was a very ordinary person, but it turned out that the child is a prodigy. So how that happened? How, where from he got the gene? So maybe the gene has got mutated. So that gene was originally none of the parents. Okay. So here, you know, if we think of it maybe as binary strings, which is one of the ways to actually model a genetic algorithm. So what we can do is actually with a very small probability. Okay, so there is another parameter which is called as mutation probability, which will have a very value very small, maybe 0.01, maybe 0.001. Okay, so if you know I get a mutation value of like that, I again randomly choose a gene and change it, or maybe if it is a binary string, which may be one of the ways of modeling our solutions, right? We'll flip the bit. Okay. So, you know, this is what is about mutation, okay? So now we are going to the pseudo code of genetic algorithm. Okay, any questions so far? Okay. So, genetic algorithm starts with initializing an initial population of candidate solutions, which we are denoted as P1 to N. So this you can think of as a maybe a multidimensional array, or you know, if in modern programming languages you can think it like a list. Okay. Now what you are going to do is you calculate the fitness value of each members. So you can understand this, right? Because before selection, you need to find the fitness value. Then what you do is from this population, okay, from this population, you create a selected population. Okay, you get a selected population, and how do you do that? You actually pick n members from P1 to n with probability proportional to the fitness. So this is the example that I just gave you, right? Okay. Now the selected 1 to n is split into two halves, and they are now randomly mate and crossover to generate offspring 1 to n. Okay. So this is one of the ways where we are not talking about the crossover probability that I talked about. Okay, not explicitly, but you can introduce it very easily. And actually, there are many variants of genetic algorithm, right? Okay. So you generated the offsprings, that is your, so you have offspring 1 to n. Now with a low probability, mutate some members of offspring 1 to n. So this actually you are you know bringing more strategy so that you know they don't get stuck at local minimum. Okay, and then what you can do is actually you have your initial set of populations, right, which are certain fitness values. So whatever, maybe you take the 5 weakest members where k equal to 5, 5 weakest members from the population. Okay, you remove them, and from the offspring, you pick up 5 strongest member and put in the population. So that way your quality of the population or quality of the, you know, quality of the set is increasing. Okay. And, you know, you continue until some termination criteria. So ultimately you return the best member of P1 to N. So here also the interesting thing is that, so if you talk about hill climbing, if you talk about simulated annealing, iterated hill climbing, whatever algorithm we have studied so far, it has given you one solution. But genetic algorithm actually returns multiple solutions, okay, and with a fitness value. So it is not necessary. So it can be possible that you apply some filtering technique and return maybe the first 2-3 good values to the user, or you can also pick up the best and give it to the user. But you get a set of solutions with their corresponding fitness value. So this is one of the other remarkable features of genetic algorithm. Okay. So just to repeat, what we are doing is that maybe we are starting with. So maybe there are, you know, 100 possible solution or maybe 10,000 possible solution. So what you have done is you have created an initial population of candidate solution. So how do you do that? You actually randomly sample maybe 100 of that. So 100 out of 10,000. So that's how you start with this 100. Now what you are doing is, for each one of these 100, you are getting the fitness value. And based on the fitness value, you are creating another set of 100. Okay. Now in this another set of 100, there is repetition possible. In the original set, there was no repetition. Now out of this 100, you split this into 50-50. Okay. And you pick one from the first set of 50 and second from the second set of 50. And then you recombine them or crossover them by the process that we have described. Okay. This you call as your offspring set. Okay. So you have 100 starting candidate solution. You still have 100 candidate solution. And then with a low probability, you apply some mutation. Okay. So maybe out of this 100, only one of them gets changed. None other gets changed. Okay. And you continue this process for some time. Okay. So there is another step. Sorry. So now what you do is you have 100, like a set of 100 solutions earlier, which you call as your initial population or maybe last generation population. And you have created a set of offspring. Now you find out that, okay, who are your strongest offspring, right? Best solution. And which are your weakest solution in your previous this thing. So you swap this. Okay. You swap this. And so, in a worst case, what you, if k is size of n, so actually you replace, continuously replace the population by completely replace your, you know, previous generation by the current generation, right? So this is also one of the parameters, and you continue this for, so with some termination. Okay, so you iterate, right? And you return the base members. So this is how actually, you know, genetic algorithm works. Okay. So let me just take a short break over here and see if you have understood.